It all started with Laura, one of the original members of the band. Her grandfather passed away, and when she went to his home in the Basque Country to gather a few belongings that he'd left her, she came across an old leather-bound book. It contained an unfinished opera that he'd secretly been working on. One of the parts of the opera was called Crystal Fighters, and it's where we got our name and our inspiration.
Set of books, one of which was this strange kind of unfinished opera.
It was just really exciting. It was full of writings, pictures.
Basque culture, Basque mythology. Once we read it and started translating bits of it, we realized it was what we really should focus on. I don't know, it's like a strange reference point, but you know, we like the visual side that comes with that strange, like, witch style hats and like multicolored clothing. Just looks completely not really of the past or the future, just anytime.
The thing which we really like is combining, as I said, that old, you know, sounds and feel, not necessarily using the instrument sometimes, but the feel of that old music that strikes the chords so deep in you.
There is nothing left here to worry about. We are on the ground, we are in the clouds, the world is spinning around.
The place which we sort of take our inspiration, this opera, wanted to like address like deep themes. It's only so long before like the, you know, the solar systems and the love and the death and all these other things are addressed.
Alone on the ground, alone on the water, alone in the clouds, alone through the clouds, alone. Born to be alone, everybody all alone, born alone to be alone, we'll stand alone forever, standing on the world alone, learning how to stand alone, and always to be alone, we'll be alone forever. We were born to be alone, everybody all alone, born alone to be alone, we'll stand alone forever, standing on the world alone, learning how to stand alone, and always to be alone, we'll be alone forever. We were born to be alone, everybody all alone, born alone to be alone, we'll stand alone.
There's some dubstep on there, techno, electro, like almost drum and bass in places, all these things, but against this sort of softer, more kind of natural sounding thing.
Standing on the world, learning how to stand.
Once we all decided we really wanted to do this, we moved into the warehouse.
In this space as well, this is where we live.
You know, living and working together, you know, of course, has its moments, you know, there's times.
I think it definitely has influenced the music and also just our approach to it. It's like, it's intense. It's like living with your band for as long as we've been doing it gets intense. And yeah, I think you can hear that sometimes.
I do this every day, I do this daily, every day I do this.
Our album arrived at, you know, playing out as a live band and then coming to record something as an album.
It seems like emotional turmoil going on up there. So, and that's part of what we like, you know, to give people a show, which is unusual.
Yeah, I think we all decided that if we were going to do this, we had to really do it right. It's like we do, like, this is what we do.
Yeah, we like to bridge the gap between the band and the sort of DJ, the club culture.
You know, often getting played, you know, build alongside people who are playing this new age sort of crossover between grime and dubstep. Our music's definitely been very much influenced, you know, by where we live, sort of in Hackney and in London.
A lot of these songs were born from Laura's grandfather's opera, and it feels really great to like play them in the sort of scenario where they were imagined. Feels like we've taken the stuff kind of back to its roots and away from the electronic urban experiment that often our music can be.
yeah. When I find my girl, love will be amazing.